In this video, we are going to see assembly language programming of PIC microcontroller. The microcontroller that we are going to use is PIC16F877A. This is the microcontroller that we have used on our development kit. So in the previous video, I have shown how to use this MPLAB software for writing programs for PIC microcontrollers. So let's begin. So here we have the opened the template file available in C drive installed folder of microchip software, and we have just opened that file for PIC16F877A microcontroller. So here is the configuration world. We have made only two changes in this. One is the WDT underscore off. So we have turned off the watchdog timer, and the other thing we have changed is we have changed the oscillator configuration. So by default it is RC oscillator. Here we have changed it to high speed oscillator. That is the requirement of our development kit. Next, so here ORG stands for origin of the program. So whenever we reset the microcontroller, the program counter will jump to this address and it will start executing the instruction from this address onwards. After that we have ORG004 hex. So this is the interrupt vector address. So it means that whenever an interrupt occurs, the microcontroller will jump to this location and it will start executing the interrupt service routine, which is written after this address location onwards. So these are the instructions, block of instructions used for saving the context of your program. And here in between these two block of codes, we have to write the interrupt service routine whenever an interrupt occurs. And this is the again block of code written to retrieve the saved context again while returning to the main program. So from this point onwards, the main program will start. Now on our development kit, we have 8 LEDs connected to port D of microcontroller. So when we want to flash the LEDs, we have to first of all configure the port D. So here, to configure the port D as output port, we have to use TRISD register. So we have to send 00 value to TRISD register, and that is done with the help of these instructions. So bank cell TRISD is used for selecting the bank in which TRISD register is present. Only then we can change or send the values to that particular register. So using this instruction, we have copied 00 value to working register, and with the help of this instruction, we have copied the value from working register to TRISD register, and hence we have made this port D as output port. Next, here we have sent FF value to port D. So when we send FF value to port D, all the LEDs will be on simultaneously. And we have here called a delay. So delay is used for keeping the LEDs on for some time. And after that, again, we have sent 00 value to port D. So when we send 00 value to port D, all the LEDs are turned off. So again, we have called delay. So this will make sure that LEDs remain off for some time. And finally, we have go to begin. So it will again jump to start, and all the program will be executed again and again. After that, we also have a delay subroutine. So whenever we want to generate a delay, at that time we can call this delay subroutine. So here what we have done is we have just taken a value, that is FF, and we have stored that value at two memory locations, that is 70 hex and 71 hex, and we have just decremented the value present at that memory location. And these are nested loops. So when to get more delay, we have to nest the loops, that is we have to write one loop inside the another. And finally, we have a return instruction which will return to the main program where it was called. And finally, we have end directive, which is used to end the program. Now to build this program, what we have to do is we have to click on this build all option, and once you click on that, it will generate a hex file, and we can now download that hex file onto our development kit. There is also a facility of checking the output on the software itself. So for that, we can go to project. We can go to view. We can go to special function SFRs, and here we can have a look at the value of port resistors. So since we are dealing with port D resistor, we can directly go and check the status of port D. So now here the status has become FF, and after some time again it will become 00. So this will make sure that the LEDs will turn on and turn off continuously, and hence the LEDs will flash after regular interval. So in the next video, we'll show the simulation of the same program on Proteus software. Thank you.